You're a knitter, and you know that wool is one of the most wonderful insulating fibers to knit with for warm garments all winter long. You've been working so hard to knit all the woolen goods, but did you know that you might be missing something that is preventing you from knitting your warmest and coziest winter wardrobe yet? Today, let's dive in on how to create the best insulation for the winter in your hand-knit wardrobe. When I learned to knit, I was living in Los Angeles, California, and knitting was more of a hobby, more of something that creates beautiful decorative garments in my life. And even though I run quite cold, the reality is I could have been fine with any knits. Any kind of wool knits would have been kept me just warm enough. Since I moved to St. Louis, I realized that there's things that I was doing that wasn't quite optimized for a true winter. And as a spinner, a knitter, a weaver, and sometimes sewist, I've been really deep diving into the different insulating qualities of fibers and how to really use them to their best advantage to knit a great winter wardrobe. So let's jump right in to my tips on knitting the warmest wardrobe yet. Firstly, the thing you have to understand is that having a very warm wardrobe isn't just about throwing on the thickest possible knit that you own. That alone will not do it. The thing that actually keeps you warm is not the wool fibers themselves, but the air being held between the wool fibers. You may already know that wool has crimp to it, and many of the wools that we use to knit our sweaters have a bit of a wavy situation going on, and the waviness is what creates space between the fibers that has air that keeps us nice and warm. So this is the same concept as why puffer jackets work. Puffer jackets have either down or polyester fill inside of them that hold a lot of air. And as your body heat warms up that air and the air stays relatively still near your body, that's what prevents the cold air from taking the heat from your body. So air being held near us and trapped near us as insulation is truly the key to getting the warmest knits. So let's talk about how that practically applies in our knitting. If you're a longtime viewer here, welcome back. You'll know that I love unspun yarns and I love knitting with unspun yarns. If you are new here, I'm so glad you're here with us. You will find out here that I often love to knit with unspun wools as well as woolen spun wools. What unspun and woolen spun wools have in common is that they are both carded and not combed. What do I mean by that? I mean that in the milling process, they take the raw fleece and they push it through what looks like a dog comb, like a dog hair comb. It has lots of little teeth in it, and it runs through, it becomes loosened up and fluffy and ready to spin, but all the fibers are not laying in the same direction. They're kind of more chaotic and tangly and weird. And the process of woolen spun or unspun yarn means that the fiber is being worked from that state directly. Very chaotic, not smoothed out. So many of my personal favorite yarns, such as Knit Picks Ecological Simply Wool, Cascade 220, Knit Picks Good Wool Linen Quill, all of these yarns have in common that they're worsted spun, which means that after they are carded, they go through an additional process of combing, which aligns all the fibers so that they're parallel to each other for a more smooth yarn before they're spun. Now, I love worsted spun yarns, don't get me wrong. But for insulating properties, you can't go wrong with woolen and unspun yarns. The chaotic, not parallel structure of the fibers within those yarns means that more air is held within that yarn. And you'll want to look for yarns that have a relatively lower grist than other yarns of the same weight. What is grist? Grist is just the measurement for how much fiber there is by weight per space that it occupies. So say that I'm looking for a worsted weight yarn to knit up this Building Blocks cardi. Because woolen spun yarn and unspun yarn has not been combed, they don't lay as flat in the yarn, and therefore it takes up less fiber to make the same amount of yarn and the same thickness. That might sound like a bad thing, but just like we talked about before, counterintuitively, less wool in the same amount of space actually means more insulation. So that's my very first tip for you. So we've talked about air being held near us, still and lovely as insulation. Let's talk about how moving air will hurt us. If you live in a cold region, you know that what's gonna get you in the end is the wind chill. Wind chill is something not to be underestimated, and you gotta take it very seriously. And when it becomes truly, truly cold, I do not wear this as outerwear. In truly frigid conditions, I'll need to add either a puffer jacket, I prefer down jackets, a woolen coat that's been boiled and felted, such as a boiled wool or melted wool coat. Those types of things will keep the wind chill out and keep any air being held by insulating layers inside. However, it can be very difficult to knit things, garments that go under coats comfortably. You'll want to look for garments that are a little bit thinner, actually, but don't worry, it's still gonna be okay because you'll have air now being held between your outer layer and your inner layers. So what I do is I wear a wool base layer, like the one I'm wearing today under this cardigan. This is 100% merino wool from the fabric store that I sewed up myself using the Lark Tee pattern by Green Line Studios. But any wool base layer will do, and then I'll layer a thinner sweater over it, such as a long sleeve version of the coloring book tee or the slightly sassy V. This winter, I'm working on arm extensions, like sleeve extension packs, expansion packs, to be included free with the patterns, just so that people who want to knit them as kind of medium, almost like a base layer, but medium, could use it that way. When you're looking for a pattern to knit that layers nicely under coats, you'll want something with a relatively tidy and trim underarm. That means compound raglan shaping or set-in sleeves will be your friend. You probably don't want something like a drop shoulder pattern because it'll have a lot more fabric under the armpits that will not comfortably fit into a sleeve. So choose your patterns for fingering, sport, DK weight patterns accordingly if you're going to use them as layering pieces under coats. So that's my second tip. If you're not able to use woolen and unspun yarn as outerwear the way that I do in late fall because it's now become too cold, I recommend going thinner and more tailored and trim under a big outer layer. That way you still have all the excellent qualities of wool layers without giving up too much. We're still using wool. You can still actually knit those using woolen spun yarn, so that is an option. Having a trim and tidy underarm means that you can layer it under all the other coats that you're gonna be wearing throughout the winter. And finally, my last tip for knitting a warm and cozy winter wardrobe is don't forget the accessories. Like I said previously, moving air, wind chill, those are the things that are gonna really hurt you. So don't leave out your hands, your neck, your ears, your toes, your ankles. Remember that you'll need to knit things for those too. And when you're knitting for those, I highly recommend looking for non-superwash wools. Knit it at a slightly denser gauge than probably you're used to for garments. I have several patterns for mittens, and all my sock patterns are compatible with non-superwash wools. If you're going to use superwash wool for practical reasons, knit them a little bit denser. Due to the fact that they're superwashed, the stitches won't want to stick together as much, because that's what superwashing does, right? It prevents felting. So because the stitches aren't going to want to stick together, as you move around in these parts of your body that there's a lot of movement on, we'll stretch out the stitches and then the wind chill comes in. So the gaps between the stitches are something you really want to avoid. And if you're going to knit using a superwash wool, I highly, highly recommend knitting it at a denser gauge. Experiment, try to find out the fabric that's most optimal for keeping those parts of our body warm, because there's nothing worse than having the perfect insulating outfit from neck to ankle, but I'm still cold because when my ankles and my hands are cold, all of me is cold. So try to pay attention to those details. Use dense fabrics in those areas that see a lot of movement and stretching around, and you'll have a much better time out in the cold. I hope that this video was helpful to you. If you're looking for patterns that are suitable for all of the things that I talked about, I've created a little collection below with links to everything that you need to know. And if you want to find out more about how to knit unspun yarn and you're feeling a little intimidated by their fragility, I highly encourage you to go watch my video about how to work with unspun yarns. I'll link that over here. I hope that you enjoy this video and that you find it helpful to you in creating a really lovely and warm winter wardrobe. Please don't forget to subscribe and comment to tell you if there's any more tips that you have for me or if there's something that you learned from this video that you'd love to implement. And if you have any questions, don't hesitate to ask them in the comments. I'll talk to you soon.